meant more to me than a lot of stuff. It made Wednesday nights worth it, I guess, is what I want to say.
VR has been a big part of my life. Every Wednesday I come here and I hang out with my friends, and it's a good place to listen to good music.
VR has been my second home for the longest time, especially right after the missions trip. And before the missions trip, like, I didn't know it, but it was, like, all the people here were always there for me, and I didn't really realize it. But now that I'm graduating and I'm probably moving on, I don't really know what to do from here, because I don't think I'll ever find a place that feels like home to me like this. So, yeah, VR is my home.
For me, VR has been a place where I can just come and know that there's going to be no pressure from anyone about drugs or alcohol or to do anything bad, because my high school is pretty bad, to put it lightly. So I'm around a lot of people who do things like that all the time. So for me, I just know that there's no one here that's gonna pressure me to do anything like that.
It's brought me great and awesome friends. They became family to me. I love them all. And it brings me closer to God.
Well, I think it's a weird question to begin with, but just being in this church for pretty much my whole life, it's just, I've seen the same people ever since I was little grow up in Christ, and just watching them kind of like mold and shape into the people that they are today has really probably been the biggest witness in my Christian walk.
Well, it's kind of become like my second home. Like, at home you have like your family, so you can like go and just like be yourself, and that's kind of like how I am here. I just come and I can be myself. Like, I don't have to worry about like whatever, like what anybody thinks of me. I can just be myself. So it just means a lot to me that like people don't judge me when I come here. People just like love me for who I am.
It's been a lot, really, because, okay, honestly, here's the thing. I like did not have that many, I didn't talk to that many people when I first came here. So I was like just out of it. And like the thing was, is what it did to me was it made me come out of my shell. And doing that, I got to see a lot of different sides of people, and like I got to see like the Spirit work through them, and it kind of inspired me, and like that it made me grow closer and closer to God, because it's like, wow, I really want to be like them. And then I feel like God was telling me like that can be you. So now I feel really good, and this is my favorite place in the world, so I'm like up here right now. It's working out.
VR has taught me a lot about God, and I've really grown in my spiritual life. I think that since I've been in VR, I've gotten a lot closer with God. I know if I haven't come here, you know, I wouldn't really have gotten as close as I am now. I think that it's shown me kind of like a cooler way of like learning through God, like not just, you know, going, oh, love next door is great. Like, I've learned more about stuff that relates to me and being a teenager and everything, and how to live life and everything like that.
Oh, geez. My first Kingdom Bound?
Kingdom Bound.
First, I'd say it was Kingdom Bound.
Kingdom Bound.
My favorite VR memories are going to Kingdom Bound.
VR memories? Probably. I love. There's something like awesome about Kingdom Bound, like every year. Something like magical, if you want to say, happens like every single year at Kingdom Bound, whether it's like everyone is like changed by God, or like we all become like really good friends. Like, I just love seeing like everyone else like love each other and love God. So probably like any Kingdom Bound year.
Me and Jocelyn Richter, yeah, JR, got into the biggest argument of our lives in our tent. Like, we were sharing our tent, and at the time we hated each other. So like we screamed at each other for a good 5 minutes, and people a campsite over thought we were gonna kill each other. So we left, and I got really sick at the Kingdom Bound, but it was the best Kingdom Bound of my life because that's where I really fell in love with God, so that's my best memory.
When Jordan was there and I had that little book light and he shined it, he shined it in Adam's face and Adam got really mad and they started fighting. It was pretty fun. That'd probably be my top favorite one.
And just that entire week is one of the best weeks out of the year.
Okay, so Kingdom Bound, oh wait, hands down. I mean, I think when it comes down to it, the list, that was my peak. Like, my coolness, it reached its highest point in that period of time. Because, like, let's see what I write here. Oh, yeah. So, that, you know, the list, that was wild. That dragged on for a while. That is in the past, though. I mean, I think that's the last time I'm going to thank someone for being attractive. Because I'm not going to live that down now, you know? But that is by far my favorite moment ever in my life, so.
Being awesome, being the first ones on Superman a few times, talks with Brett Allman, like card games like Mao and Spoons and doing stuff like that. The Guts sleepover was pretty sweet. Winning the Turkey Bowl for the first time, even though we didn't win, I've always gone and I'm so happy that we finally won. Handshakes with Brittany, and we can try to add to it, it's pretty fun. Ask to see it sometime. I don't know, just general all the games we played, all the stuff I've learned, and just having fun over here, I guess.
Eating a lot of food with Natalie, and just meeting people, going to the concerts, and doing a missionary trip, which was to the Dominican Republic. I had an awesome time there, like, serving little kiddies, kids, and just like, having them lead themselves to Christ and just hugging them and thinking about, I met an awesome guy, Matt Carrillo, but that's a sidetrack, no thing.
Okay, so I was in seventh grade. It was when Eunice was still here, and it was, I think, the Christmas party we had here, and we went all out caroling. Like, it was bad. I lost my voice by the end of the night. And like while we were caroling, she had, you know, those bubble tape, those 6 feet bubble tape things. And we both had about like half of it in our mouths. So we're trying to sing these carols with like this big wad of gum in our mouths. It was just terrible. We're screaming at the top of our lungs, getting all into it. And by the end of the night, I couldn't say a word. It was fun, but you know, I paid the price. I can speak for like the next 2 weeks. So
it's hard to sum it up into just one thing. I would say the biggest memory was the whole Dominican Republic trip. That just changed my whole life. Everything I saw there was just amazing. I really can't even explain how awesome it was.
Pasty Matt, probably Rick, and Lance, just because I throw him in there.
Yeah. Rick, definitely, because, well, first of all, I make sure I give him a hug every time before I leave. He's the one who comes up to me a lot and gives me a hug. That just starts off my day well. Rick's always there to talk to me. He, I don't know why, he just seems like a nice guy to talk to. I always go to him if I need someone to talk to. I recently just did a public speaking project on Rick and interviewed, so I actually learned more about it. But he's a really interesting guy and helps out a lot, and I think that he deserves props.
Well, Christy, she was the first person that I met at VR, and the reason why she sticks out is because she was with me before I was Jocelyn. She knew me even when I was Wes's sister, you know, just that little quick time period. But yeah, she worked it out for me. She stands by me, man. And then Anna, she totally changed me, basically. I'm like way cooler now because I know her. And this changed person right here gets to be in her wedding, so props.
I'd like to give a shout out to Pastor Dan. He's been huge influence in my life. it's just good to know that we have one of the best youth pastors around.
If you ask me, I love Paula. She's amazing. She's so cool. And she's always, you know, she's got it together. Nothing surprises her. She's just always cool about everything, so.
All of them, but like, if I had to narrow it down to my top three, Meg Piccarolo would be number one because she's my hero. She found my passport in a foreign country. If she wouldn't have, I would have been stuck there. Anna Salone, she was there for me in a really hard time of my life when Ari, my little brother, was sick, and she helped me get back on my path. And Rick, he's been my big brother for the longest time, so I really look up to him. He's really cool too.
Probably my sister, cliche, but she has literally been like my like supporter, like my mentor. She's basically gotten me through like everything, even being like thousands of miles away in Australia. She's just helped me through all of my high school issues and whatever it was. Yeah, she's been my best friend for my whole life.
My girlfriend, Megan Piccarolo, I love her. We have sleepovers every day. And my senior tribe leaders, Rick Smazinek, Ricky, and Christy McGee, they're awesome. All the leaders I love because Matt Crouch, all of them, I don't know all the names, I have bad memory. But they're all awesome and I love them. Pastor Dan's awesome. Seriously, my favorite uncle. He's like an uncle to me because I've known him for 18 years. Like me and Emily. Off track, but PD's awesome, I love him, and he's saved a lot of my friends, which makes me feel happy.
A good shout out to Mike Norman and Rick Smazniak. And you're both awesome. Okay, and next question.
Okay, when you really come here, you gotta let loose and don't let shyness or whatever else overtake you, because I think that when you open up here, that's the only way that you're gonna grow in God, and you're not gonna have as much fun as you should be at this type of place. So yeah, basically do you, but be chill. Don't be uptight when you come in here, because it's not gonna work out. But also, PS, good thing to look forward to when you get here. And when you're senior, it's gonna be awesome because you get to go to 110. Put that in the VR yearbook. See that?
I really think that there's a lot that I could say, but to narrow it down, like, you just should treat yourself and others around you with respect. Because if you show yourself respect first, then you're gonna get respect. So if you dress a certain way when you first come in, and by the end, like, of my 6 years that I've been here, you dress a different way, that's a good thing. Like, but you can always be true to yourself no matter what here, so I guess people change you, or you change yourself because the grace of God tells you to. That's all I gotta say.
New kids, don't be scared. I may be really, like, crazy and stuff, but I'm really fun.
All I can say is, as students, school isn't gonna be the rest of your life. So if anything happens, don't worry about it. It probably won't matter to you in 20 years. So don't stress. Just go with it for now. It'll be okay.
So I definitely get that it's uncomfortable, but don't ever change yourself just so others will like you, because I guarantee you, you'll regret it somewhere along the road. I've tried that, you know, because it has been lonely being a Christian in high school, but, you know, most of the kids are weird anyways, you don't want to be friends. So just, you know, stay with your faith. Don't ever lose that, no matter what, because really that's the only thing that's going to get you through anything in life, is your faith. And just be yourself. Don't try to do something you're not, because people will see right through that.
For VR students now, I would say don't be afraid to bring your friends in, like, as often as you can, because you think they'll think it's not cool.
You'll be seeing a lot of me because I'm not going anywhere, I'm going to school local, so.
Tell them to have fun. Live a good life. Yeah.
Stay strong through all your tough times. Don't care what anyone else thinks. Obviously, you're going to be different. It's not that bad. You can deal with it. And keep God number one in your life. Stay throughout.
You being shy and you just going with it. Hold on, I messed up.
Over the years.
Just stop it.
I was thinking about we'll
I'm
edit.
Trying to think.
Wow.
I would say Rick. I mean, Rick has stood out to me. We're doing interviews here.
Oh my God.
For me, VR has been a place where I can come and know that there's not going to be any pressure from anyone.
Had to.
Really,
sorry.
Guys?
No, he's not back there. It's just me.
Any VR leader you'd like to give a shout out to?
Oh, my girlfriend. She's really pretty.
That's what
up. And this one. That one too.
Staring.
Yeah.
Hello. We're gonna put this over here.
I have to say something to Mike. No, oh wait, I can't say that on camera.
Rick!
Are you in the middle?
Interrupted me!
See? Look at this. I can't work like this. I'll be in my trailer.